Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Ridler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Monday after, quite a weekend. I hope you had a good weekend in your studio. Remember, your life is your studio. And mine was like this. Because I had the great good pleasure of going to the big neighborhood yard sale. Yay! And also the Beaches Arts and Crafts sale, which was a total fluke and accident, but was absolutely wonderful. But in between those things, I was feeling really poorly. So Friday night, I was feeling not so great. Saturday morning, I was okay. Saturday afternoon and evening, I slept, just slept. And then Sunday, my absolutely favorite kind of summer day, blue skies, sunshine, very heavy breezy, and, you know, under 25 degrees. So it was delicious. And that's when I said to Justin, let's walk down to the beach. And we did. And we stumbled on the sale. So I promised you on Friday that I would show you if I got stuff. And I didn't get super, super much. But how could I resist this? This was at the neighborhood yard sale. Because what have we been talking about? But Inspiration Rabbit and Procrastination Bunny. And so when this little friend said hi to me from somebody's yard sale, I had to say yes. And I'm afraid this one, Procrastination Bunny. But very sweet nonetheless, and an absolute treasure. Apparently, this bunny had been in the family since the 1970s, believe it or not. And so I thought that he needed a good home here with me. Thank you, bunny. So that was a big treat. I really, really, really love puppets. In fact, I still think about taking some classes in puppeteering. At the same place, I got this wonderful old calendar by the artist Mucha. And I just, how could I resist? Because every page seems to me like it would be an exquisite journal cover. Wonderful. That was it, other than a beautiful mirror we got for the front hallway, which I can't take down to show you. We had a couple of big IKEA lamps that were quite a to-do to carry home. They're kind of those lamps that add more glow than light, but sometimes that's really nice to create some atmosphere. As you know, I like the glow. Then at the arts and crafts sale in the Beaches, Justin and I walk by three tables that were selling really nice wood cutting boards. And just, but I really liked the first man we saw selling them. He was just, had this nice energy around him, and he was very nice and approachable. And so we went back to his table, and we've been looking for a good cutting board for a long time. And then I liked this one, and Justin liked that one. And we agreed that if we got rid of all the ones we had that kind of sort of worked, that we could get these two new ones. Besides, you always need two cutting boards so that when someone's over for dinner and they say, can I help? You can go, yes. So this is the one that I picked out. It is walnut, and it's so beautiful. And then Justin picked out this maple one because Justin loves contrast. The man who made these, Kjell Orling. Thanks, Kjell. I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly. What a treat! And the other treat we got there was the best tasting honey I've ever had from a company called The Art of Nova Scotia. And they let us taste lots of honeys, which was brilliant because, of course, we brought home three. But the one that just is spellbinding was lemon honey. I could keep snipping a little taste, a little taste, a little taste, and never stop. So that was a wonderful adventure and such a joy. The weather was a delight. Justin and I just walked around with our coffees and took in the atmosphere and enjoyed all the wonderful creative energy and the neighborhood energy. And so that part of the weekend was just inspiring and a blessing. And speaking of inspiring, I have been getting so many wonderful questions and requests for collage videos, for videos talking about the magazines I use, which, you know, I talked a lot about them on Friday and showed you a bunch that I just took in, about gluing techniques for really creating nice and flat surfaces for your collage, about different ways of collaging, about different kinds of collage journals. And so just know, like, the ideas are brewing of how can I address all of these? What's the best way to answer all these questions and to get everyone started so beautifully on their adventure with collage, or deepening or expanding their adventure with collage? So if you have a collage question, be sure to send it to me, Jamie, J-A-M-I-E, at openthedoor.ca, or leave it below in the comments. And I'll keep working on how can I bring this all together in a way where it feels like a comprehensive approach to collage. I've been wanting to do, too, a class on journaling. We've got Journal Club going on, which is just the greatest. And if you didn't join us for the summer, I hope you've already got your eyes on joining us for the fall. But I was also thinking in the fall of doing a six-week sampler of different kinds of journaling. It would give us an opportunity to try something for a week and see if it fits us. And you could have some support if you were trying something and wanted to make adjustments, or something wasn't quite working for you, or you didn't quite understand something. You'd have some support. And then you'd have six different kinds of journaling at your fingertips. So maybe from Fibonacci's to the negative space journal to the collage a day project. And I think that would be so much fun. I hope it sounds like fun for you too. I'm really, you can see my brain's already like, I'm following the inspiration rabbit. Oh, I also had art day with my sister Shannon on Sunday. We do that every 2 weeks. And this week we decided to just do our own thing, whatever we felt like. She was testing out her new gel pens. And I got into one of the magazine journals that I've been creating, and I had started just gluing pictures into it, just basically wanting to cover up all the text and create a picture book. Do you remember me talking about that? And I just knew this magazine is going to become something, but I didn't know what, and I still don't quite. But one thing I discovered was that as I started to fill the pages, then I started to have fun kind of treating it a little bit like a dollhouse, you know, like a little bit like placing, oh, I'll stick this cat on top of that chair, or, oh, I'm going to make that lady sit on the corner of that mountain. And that has been so much fun. In fact, that started to become so much fun, I didn't want to put it down. And yes, I will do a flip through of that too. I did get my head for my Vanguard tripod, so I'm going to be trying that out this week. This feels like a time of inspiration infusion, as I talked to you about on Friday. But for me, it's also a place of gaining ground. I really feel like I'm figuring out the next level of equipment and systems and support that I need for Jamie Ridler Studios to grow. And if you are a member of the studio, which I hope you are, and you can be over at openthedoor.ca, on the free resource page, which you can always find by going to the end of your newsletter, there's a link to it there, you'll see that I have a page for you of everything I use in my creative business at Jamie Ridler Studios. So what do I use to host audios? What do I use to edit the podcast? What do I use to edit the BTS? And for those of you who are starting out, or those of you who, like me, are always refining what you're doing, it really helps when we share our knowledge. And that lifts us all up and helps us all bring our creative dreams to life. And that is what it's all about here in the studio. So I hope you have a wonderful day in your studio, and I will see you on Wednesday.